basically, I blacked out and bought a lot of books. Hey friends, what is up and welcome back to my channel. As you can tell from the title of today's video, some shit happened. Basically, I blacked out like 3 or 4 times this week and bought a bunch of books. Some of these are from Amazon. Well, one of these is from Amazon. I try not to buy on Amazon. You guys know that. One of these is from my local bookstore. One of these, or a couple of these, are from Barnes & Noble. Basically, I just went ham this week. I cleared up a lot of space on my shelves. I did move some stuff around because I try to contain what I call my book mess to only my shelves. And then also I got a book cart, which is right there. That is where I put all the books, or I am putting all the books that I am buying to read. And essentially, if I don't read them from that book cart, they go onto a specific shelf that sits next to my desk. And if within a year they are not off of that shelf, that means I need to unhaul them. And that is what I have been doing recently. And so I wanted to replenish my book cart. I wanted to put some books on there that I'm really excited to read. Some of these I did include in my wrap up. I will list that up above for you guys. Some of these I have already read and I will not try to give you a review on them. I'm just going to talk about what I have, like why I bought them, that kind of thing. So I'm going to go ahead and get started because I do have quite a few. So the first ones that I want to talk about are the first 4 books in the Old Republic series. So 2 of these I have read, so they will be going straight to my shelves. First one I have here is Revan. Obviously, Revan is about Revan and a little bit of his story. I would say this doesn't have a whole lot of backstory. Of the books that I have read, this is my least favorite of the 2 that I have read so far in the, like, my chronological reading of the Old Republic books. So not my favorite, but it is still cool. I like Revan as a character, but I think I like him more in, like, the games, like Sweater. I like him a lot more in Sweater than I think I do in here, even though he's not really a main character in the games. He's just, like, this character that you sort of interact with, like his legend. But I think that you get a lot more from the game. If you are interested, you should definitely play it. It's a lot of fun. I play it all the time. I've just been wanting to play it over the last couple of days. I've been in, like, a really big Star Wars kick. I actually finally watched The Last Jedi, and if you follow me on Instagram, you will have seen me basically bawling my eyes out and word vomiting about how much I loved it. So it did spur me picking up these books. The next one that I have is Deceived. This is all about Malgus. Malgus is one of my absolute favorite Sith lords, and I felt like this was a lot more interesting. Now, let it be known, these are written by different authors. So this is Drew Capation and this is Paul S. Kemp. So the books are written by different authors. They're not all written by the same. And I feel like Paul does a lot, and I feel like he does a better job of explaining characters, because I really, really enjoyed Malgus. And if you're not familiar with Malgus, he is a Sith Lord, but he also has a soft spot for his Twi'lek, I want to say, like, girlfriend, who's basically his slave. And that plays a lot into this book. And it does also cover the sacking of Coruscant, which is, if you've played the game, one of the most beautifully cinematic. I remember reading this and then being like, all right, now I want to watch that scene from the game. It was just a lot of fun. And it's really, it was, I think, the best representation for me of, like, how fucked up Sith can be, because this Malgus did not mess around. The next ones that I have, I haven't read yet. Don't really know what they're about. I would prefer to do it that way. This one is written by Sean Williams, and this one is once again written by Drew Capation. I have Fatal Alliance as well as Annihilation. So I did pick up these as well. Like I said, don't know a whole lot about what these are about because I'm trying to just read them and experience them and not really spoil myself for it. The next book that I have here was sent to me from Viz Media, and I will list up above in the cards the vlog where I sort of talk about this, and it is called Automatic Eve. I am almost done. I have about 50 pages left of it. This was translated from Japanese into English, and because of that, I was a little bit worried that I wasn't going to like it because I'm very picky when it comes to translations. I feel like a lot of it is lost in translation, and I'm pleasantly shocked that I really enjoy this. This is, I want to say short stories, but kind of not. So basically, it is telling an overall story that follows a man who makes robots. So he makes robotic people, crickets, everything. And the characters that kind of come in and out of his life, and it is told from their perspective for each different, I don't want to say chapter, but, like, each different, like, story section. And it's really cool. So the first story that got me hooked is, just as a little bit of a taste here, is about a man who falls in love with a concubine, essentially, and because he knows that she won't love him when he is able to free her with a large sum of money from cricket fighting, he decides to free her and then enlist the man who kind of runs through the whole story to create a robot that reminds him of her. He finds out, or he starts thinking that that woman is not actually the robot, and he ends up killing her and finding out that it is actually just the woman that he is in love with. And so there's a lot of that in this story. There's a lot about what makes a soul a soul. There's a lot about, like, how adding robotics and, you know, like, AI to our bodies, how they can kind of develop a mind of their own. Eve is also another character that sort of runs through the whole story as well, and I feel like she's getting more and more human the more I read the story. So my friend AJ, I'll list AJ's channel down below, has really been into AI and that kind of thing recently. He got me kind of like into it even more, so that is why I decided to pick this up next. Very easy to read. I feel like it's written very well, even though it is translated, and I would recommend it. I like it a lot. All right, the next couple of books that I have here, the next one that I want to talk about is one that was in my wrap-up that you guys will have already seen. So I'm going to briefly just talk about this. This is The Right Swipe. This follows our main character Rhiannon as well as Samson. Things are told in dual perspective between the two of them. Rhiannon basically owns something similar to Twitter, and Samson works for something similar to Match. And Rhiannon is attempting to purchase that company, and Samson is the nephew, essentially, of the woman who owns our Match equivalent. This has a lot of really good representation, I think, for anxiety and sexual abuse and verbal abuse and mental abuse, as well as a lot of good representation for what it is, how it is for sports, like people who play sports, like sports players, athletes, I guess is what you would call them, and traumatic brain injuries, especially when it comes to football. So I did like that, but I'll leave it up to you guys to watch whether or not you want to see what I think thought of it in my wrap-up. Like I said, I'll list it up above for you guys. The next book I have here is Pumpkinheads by Faith Erin Hicks and Rainbow Rowell. You guys know I'm not really the biggest fan of Rainbow. I like her shorter books, like her short stories, but I'm not really a fan of like her bigger volumes. But I fucking loved this. So it follows our main character Josiah and Deja, and they work on this like autumny pumpkin like farm essentially, and there's like candy corn and pumpkin flavored things and a lot of like succotash, and it's just like a big, I don't know what you want to call it, but essentially that's where they work. They have like mazes and the typical place that the basic would go for their autumn like excursion. And it's about Josiah trying to talk to the girl that he's been in love with the entire time. What I liked about this book is our main character Deja dates a lot and she's bisexual, and I fucking loved that. I like that it was so casually mentioned, like Josiah's like, oh, which Jess or like which person that you dated, because she does date a lot. And I think that that's normal and that happens. And I appreciated the representation for that in the story, as well as it was so casual that Deja has multiple partners as well as male and female. Also, Deja is on the plus side and I fucking loved that. And it was a very, very cute love story. It's a lot about them like running through the farm trying to find this girl and like them like talking about their friendship throughout the entirety of the story. Very cute. I don't know if there's going to be a second one. I kind of hope not, because I think that it had a good ending, but I'm pleasantly surprised that I ended up enjoying it. The next two books that I have here kind of go together. One of them I have already read. So I have Heartstopper Volume 1 and Heartstopper Volume 2. This is, I don't know, I would say one of the cutest books I've ever read. So the first one that I have read, and I'm assuming the second one will also be, about these two gentlemen falling in love, one of which is already out of the closet because he has been outed by his peers, unfortunately, and another one who is just sort of discovering what it means that he likes the other boy. I'm sorry that I can't remember their names right now. I read the first one very, very late in the evening, and I'm just terrible with names in general, but this was just cute. Like I this is all I've ever wanted in a male romance comic. Like, it was very much so, I think, like honest, because one of the main characters in this book is kind of harassed by an ex-boyfriend, and it does focus on that. And then there is a lot of just them becoming friends and falling in love, and it was just adorable. And I can't wait to read the second one. I am going to be bringing that one with me to Florida. The next book that I have was also sent to me by Viz Media, Nibby Levius. This is a manga, but the interesting thing about this manga is it is written front to back, as opposed to back to front like traditional manga are. This is massive, but I'm really excited to read it because it says, as society rises from the ashes of war, cybernetically augmented arena fighters battle for fame and fortune or die trying. So this is a lot of arena battling, which is something that I've always been really interested in, as well as it is augmented people, so people who are part robotic. And that was, I'm excited. So after reading Automatic Eve, or starting to read Automatic Eve, I think that this is going to be right up my alley. So I am going to try to bring this with me to Florida. But like I said, it is fucking massive, but I am still excited to finally, well, eventually get around to reading it. All right. The next book I have here, I also mentioned in my wrap up, but I did want to mention here, some people only watch hauls, some people only watch wrap ups. So I didn't want to kind of encompass everything. And that would be Every Heart a Dory by Seanan McGuire. I'm not going to linger here for too long, but essentially this book follows a school for wayward children. And they are children who have come back from basically alternate reality. So they are able to go through these little doorways and they go to different places. Some of them are really fantastical and beautiful and nice. And some of them are really cruel and cold and calculating. And they kind of run on different like latitude and longitudes than we normally do. And that is how they are able to find where they are from. And I loved this. I feel like it was very whimsical, which is what I wanted at the time. This is a great fall read, I think, if you are interested, but I definitely will be picking up the rest of them. The next one I got, I'm also not gonna stay here for too long because it is the fourth in the series, but it'd be again, volume 4. And this follows two main characters who go back in time. So they are getting ready to graduate high school. One's really popular, one's not very popular, and they go back in time to kind of save this club that they are now a member of in their time jump backwards. And I really like it. I think that the third volume really is what kept me wanting to read because you're getting a lot more of the backstory on the characters, you're finding out different things about them. And I really enjoyed that. So I'm glad I picked up the next one. This next one that I have to talk about was actually sent to me from DC, and I'm really excited, and I'm not 100% sure on what it's about, but that is for a very specific reason. This is Harley Quinn Breaking Glass. I know DC is doing like a teen version of a lot of their main characters. So we have Harley Quinn in this, as well as Ivy, I believe, which is why I'm not kind of trying to find out what this is about, because I love Ivy so fucking much. She is my favorite of the DC universe. And then obviously I do also really like Harley Quinn. Really excited to read this. I read Raven, the like teen version of Raven last month and loved it. So I'm excited to read this one, get a little bit more of, I don't know if it's canon, so I'm going to say alternate version of Harley and Ivy when they are much, much younger. Now, I have 5 more books, 3 of which I purchased, 2 that are from the library. The last of the books that I purchased are The Sister of the Winterwood. So it says on the back, in a remote village surrounded by vast forests, Liba and Leia have been raised on the honey-eyed scent of their mammies, Babka, and the low rumble of their Tati's prayers. But when dark forces threaten their village, the sisters discover a family secret passed down through generations. Faced with a magical heritage they never knew existed, Liba and Leia realize the old fairy tales are true and could save them all. So I'm excited for this because it sounds a lot like some of my favorite stuff to read are the dark and spooky kind of Russian folklore-esque books. So if you've heard me talk about The Bear and the Nightingale, for one, that is one of my absolute favorites, as well as, I would say, what is it called? The Grisha Trilogy by Leigh Bardugo has a little bit of that in here as well. But this just sounds like magic and mystery and like darkness and like Russian folklore. And it's some of my favorite stuff to read. So that's why I picked it up. The only thing I'm sad about this book is it has deckled edges, which are my least favorite form of books to buy. So maybe I'll read that and then sell it. I don't know. The last 2 books that I purchased is Middle Game by Seanan McGuire because I had to grab this. I've heard Books and Lala rave about this. I've heard Rachel rave about this. Everybody I know that kind of has similar taste in me, I was like, if they think it's good, it's probably good. I'm going to go ahead and pick it up. So I did grab this. I don't want to know what this book is about. Like even when Lala talked about it, she was like, I really like this book. And I was like, click off. You don't want to know what it's about. So I'm excited to read it. I feel like for me, Seanan is my newest, most interesting author. I wouldn't say favorite because I haven't read enough from her, but definitely the most interesting. So that's why I grabbed this one. And the last book that I purchased is a book that I'm very excited about. And that would be Where I End and You Begin by Preston Norton. You guys know Neanderthal Opens the Door to the Universe. It was one of my very favorite books when I first read it. It was my favorite book of the year. Absolutely love that book. I've never laughed so hard. I've never felt so much. And that is what I think this book is going to be for me. This is about a boy and a girl who do sort of switch places. It's like Invasion of the Body Snatchers. Essentially, they switch places. They switch bodies. But they start to realize they kind of like living in the other person's body. And I'm hoping that means there's going to be some amazing rep in the story because I feel like Preston really understands and gets it. And I think that he's going to do it very well. And I'm really excited to read it. I will let you guys know. I'm definitely going to be trying to pick this up in the month of September. I might bring this with me to Florida. Now, the last 2 books that I have here are my library books. First one, once again, I would say I heard Lala. Basically, I've heard everybody talk about this, and it'd be Wilder Girls. I didn't want to buy it, though, because as gorgeous as this cover is, I've heard the book is a little bit lackluster. People either really, really fucking love it or really, really hate it, and I'm not sure where I'm going to fall. So I wanted to read it and then possibly purchase it if I do like it. I don't know anything about Rory Power. I don't know anything about this book. I just know that a lot of people either love it or hate it, and that piqued my interest. And the last book that I have to talk about is a book that I actually had pre-ordered but ended up having to cancel my pre-order, and I felt really bad about it. But if I like it, I am going to go and purchase it, and it'd be An Absolutely Remarkable Thing by Hank Green. You guys know Hank and John Green are my two favorite people. I'm going to leave a video at the top of my description bar for Good Mythical Morning if you watch it, but it has Hank and John on there, and I feel like it's such a good representation of both of them. If you want to know a little bit more about them, I gush about those two men. I absolutely love them. But I did pick up An Absolutely Remarkable Thing. This is a YouTuber writing about a YouTuber consumed by a YouTuber, and I think that's really interesting to me. So basically, Hank wrote a book about a girl and her friend who become overnight sensations by recording something, and they become overnight sensations on YouTube and dealing with the aftermath of that. And that's why I want to read this, because it's a YouTuber writing about a YouTuber to be consumed by me, a YouTuber. So it's kind of cyclical in a way. I'm really excited to read this. I know most people who have read this fucking love it, and that is what I'm excited for, because I'm hoping a lot of Hank's personality comes through in this book. All right, friends, so that is everything that I have purchased, been sent, or have gotten from the library in the last, I would say, month and a half. Some of these, as you can tell, I only had two library books this month, and it's because I really want to focus on reading the books that I am bringing in. So if I buy like five books in the beginning of the month, I'm only gonna get one or two books from the library. These two books I already had on hold, so they did kind of come in at the same time, and that's why I have them at all. But I do wanna focus a lot on reading when I'm bringing in. If I only buy like one book in the month, then maybe I'll get five or six books from the library. But that is how it's gonna be from this point on. I know I just uploaded a haul. I'll leave it up in the cards for you guys, but here's another one. I blacked out and went absolutely crazy. Let me know down below the last book that you purchased. Did you read it automatically? Did you just put it on your shelves? Let me know down below, but I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video.